When I was in high school, I used to have a friend that said we shouldn't hide away when we smoke weed. People have this idea of weed smokers as shady individuals because some of them seem like they're scared to be seen using it. People think people who are trying to hide something are doing something wrong. There's nothing wrong with smoking weed, so we shouldn't have to hide it. I feel the same way about eating pills. Going to the bathroom to use them seems like a tacit admission that we're doing something wrong. Last month, I proudly swallowed some pills in front of this horrid sack of shit of a human being, and she looked at me and said, "How charming," in a sarcastic voice. I asked her if she even knew what the pill was that I was taking, and she said no. Unfortunately, this is a common attitude towards people and their pill habits, and it's no better than the people in the past who said, "How can you stand up for marijuana? Marijuana is a drug. It makes people sick, addicted, and died. Marijuana is a drug, and it is bad." Just by classifying marijuana as a drug, people thought of it like heroin without any investigation. So how is the person who judges pill use to be a bad thing without even knowing what the pill is or how it affects you any better than those people who disapprove of marijuana use? I've seen pills make good people into scumbags, getting us sickly and addicted and die. Hey, pill is not a classification of drug. Pill is a way to distribute many different kinds of drugs. If someone told you they disapprove of drug use, you'd call them out for being an automized, cocksucking, homophobic, tool of the DARE programs, Gestapo, Nazi, child molesting police officers. That's pretty much what they're saying if they disapprove of your pill habit. They might as well be saying don't use drugs if they don't even know what the drug is. Don't tolerate your friends getting smug with you over pills. It's not always better to use natural remedies. You can trust that at least one person, me, doesn't respond well to natural remedies. And if you say I'm doing it wrong, well, I'm still not responding to it, am I? I'll tell you why pills improved my life, and if any of this sounds like you, they might improve your life too. I'm a naturally happy person, but I'm not always productive. My life as a kid consisted of laying, sitting, laying, playing video games while laying, and sleeping. I had a cot on top of a bed. Under the bed, I tried to have everything I ever needed so I could avoid getting up. I skipped middle school for this. I made a good attempt to be productive in high school, but lethargy is burned into my brain. I actually like to rest a lot when I'm not on Tramadol, and this isn't a withdrawal from Tramadol. I've had fatigue problems long before I ever took prescription drugs. I think a lot of people do. Tramadol makes me more productive and puts me in a better mood. Neurontin puts me in a better mood, too. Even though I'm not totally anxiety-ridden without prescription drugs, I'm not consistently confident without them. I can now plan to have a nice day every day, which I can never plan with weed and alcohol, which were my drugs of choice as a kid. Neurontin and Tramadol have drastically improved my life, and I consider it arrogance of Dr. Drew proportions for someone else to tell me I'd be better off without them. There's a reason to use drugs even if you're already happy with how your life is going, because there's always a greater level of happiness and productivity that can be achieved. The only reason not to use drugs is if the negative side effects outweigh its benefits. That's where Dr. Drew Penis Breath always gets it wrong. He just always says it's addiction in the face of negative consequences. Some drugs do have negative side effects, so I'm told, and it's up to the person and in some cases other people to decide if that drug's worth taking. I've used Tramadol for over a year and Neurontin for about 8 years, and I have not noticed any major negative side effects. Tramadol can make you a little sick if you eat over 200 milligrams in the same half hour, but that's not a big side effect and it's easily avoidable. Back to the vile scum that insulted me for pill use, she made a point that she didn't like the aggressive vibe I put out. Now how selfish is it of someone like her to not want someone like me to use a drug that has massively improved my life because someone like her doesn't like my non-violent personality changes when I'm on it. Obviously, for people who get violent and steal because of drugs, other people have the right to keep them from using drugs, but it's the people who are to blame. Only simple-minded, obedient cretins blame the drug instead of the person. I know several people who use all different kinds of drugs who manage their use without hurting other people, so keeping them from their drug of choice is just cruel. Even hard drugs can be beneficial. Painkillers make me get a lot of stuff done, helps fight sleep deprivation. They make me feel radically happy. When I first decided to start eating pills proudly in front of people was when my friend came into my room to see me in a tutu snorting oxy. See, before I left for Hawaii, it was okay to use painkillers occasionally, but when I got back, many of the townspeople had gotten addicted to smoking oxy 80s. That friend gave me the worried about you speech about 5 times before I stopped being nice and told him to shut the fuck up. After that, I started using painkillers once a week for the next 2 years, proudly telling all the townspeople what I was doing. I had to stop because my tolerance got too high, but I noticed no negative side effects from using heavy amounts of opiates one day a week.
Your body might be different. I can't use dopaminergic stimulants because the withdrawal is too hard for me to stand.
How did my friends get so brainwashed that they now believe any use of oxycodone is bad? We didn't start out that way. We questioned what we were told, but now many of my friends just nod their head. Oxycodone bad, government heroin. We're rebels who think for ourselves because we all have tattoos and support marijuana legalization. Everybody you know has tattoos and supports marijuana legalization, you bitches. I believe in the freedom to use any drug, because I'm really pro-drugs, unlike those people who do one drug but then look at someone who smoked meth as a vampire stereotype thief of a meth head, even if that person hasn't done any harm to anybody else. I'm really pro-drugs, unlike that every color of deception piece of trash neurosuit. I saw how brainwashed my friend was when he tried to give me the worried about you speech. I got sort of a different lesson than he intended to convey. I decided then that everyone needed to see people that benefited from using pills. I decided then to never hide the pills that I use. If productive, functional, likable people hide the pills that they use, then all the average person sees is a flawed statistic. The people who fuck up on pills are the only ones who get noticed. We all have the ability to decide if someone's behavior is unacceptable. We shouldn't blame the chemical when the same chemical can drastically improve somebody else's life.
People who think of pill habits as bad and something to be gotten off of are no better than the people who think of marijuana as bad and something to be gotten off of. And we should call these vile people out for the arrogant scum they are.